Oh, the Podfather. Do you like that phrase, Adam Carolla?
Sure, I'll take it.
All right. The Prince of Podcasting, and of course, great success in radio and TV. A new movie about censorship and cancel culture. We'll talk about No Safe Spaces in a second. Was it a safe space, Adam, on the goodbye to Bean, on the Kevin and Bean show? And then, is ambush the right word? That's probably not a fair word. When Poor Man called in.
Poor Man hosted Loveline years before I got there, and then left after a big kerfuffle with Bean and audience and on air, and has been sort of angry ever since. Mm. Poor Man has done with me and Loveline and Kevin and Bean what Adam Schiff is doing with President Trump. Just won't let it go. So he's been coming after him for 26 years. He finally called in on the last episode, and we just put him on the air.
And did you have any trepidation about that, or?
I don't care. Like, I'm too old to trepidate anymore. Right. My trepidating days are behind me.
Okay.
We should all put our trepidations behind us. We just went, this is good radio. Like, this guy we haven't talked to in 26 years is finally calling in. And also, I hosted Loveline, but I didn't replace him. Mm-hmm. I replaced Ricky Rackman, who came after him.
Sure.
So I don't have a dog in the fight. I just have a dog at home.
There we go. One thing that I was struck by, and you must feel the same way, you, Jimmy Kimmel, so many tremendous alums from that show.
Yeah, Jimmy. I met Jimmy there in 1994. Carson Daly, we brought in there. Chris Hardwick, Virgin Kennedy, or Kennedy as we now know her. I mean, there were so many, and I'm forgetting a few, Dr.
Sure.
Drew. There were so many people that were in that world back when nobody was anybody. I mean, Jimmy was Jimmy the sports guy. I was his boxing coach. Like, it was a weird time to be at K-Rock.
But did you get the sense ever that something cool is going to happen to all these people, or?
I'm still not sure anything cool has ever happened to any of us.
Well,
we all just got old.
It's not going too badly. All right, this whole idea, no safe spaces, you're working with Dennis Prager on this.
Yeah.
And what prompted your involvement in this?
I love Dennis Prager. I've always listened to his shows. I'm a sort of a talk show, radio talk show junkie, so I've always listened to him and many other personalities. And we had worked together and done some tours and done some speaking engagements, and we're both big fans of each other. So somebody said, do you want to work with Dennis Prager? And I said, absolutely, that'll be fun.
And then the idea being what? How is 2019 different than 10 years ago?
We started noticing, we had an appearance for CSUN Northridge, and it got canceled. And we noticed some other folks getting their appearances canceled. And I started talking to comedian friends of mine, and they said, we were not playing colleges anymore. It's too big a hassle. Mm-hmm. We don't want to deal with it. And I started noticing in my community, the comedy community, and Dennis noticed in his community as well, that there's a lot of people being canceled and asked not to speak on college campuses. And we thought, what's going on college campuses? So we thought we'd sort of take a deep dive into what was going on.
And what, campuses. In the course of that deep dive, what did you discover?
Well, we discovered that, I'm telling you, all roads lead back to the self-esteem movement. Everyone thinks self-esteem is a good idea. It's good if you earn it. It's not good if someone just bestows it on you when you're 9 and tells you you're the best. And anyone who differs with you is wrong. And then a whole group of these people end up at a place called college. And then somebody shows up, like Ben Shapiro, who they disagree with. And all these people with super high self-esteem who are 19 go, that guy's not allowed to exchange ideas we disagree with here on this campus. And because they think their vote matters, because they grew up that way. Like, I grew up feeling like a piece of garbage. Who cares what you said? You know, be seen and not heard. These guys don't feel that way. They feel like, could you imagine when you're 19 and some 40-year-old was going to speak on campus and you're like, not on my watch? Or you'd be like, oh, I'm going to go throw the frisbee in the quad, and that guy can talk. Right. I can't tell him what to do. Like, when does your opinion matter? Who decided that 19-year-olds knew anything? I mean, look how empowered everybody is. You don't know anything. What did you know when you were 19?
Yeah. Right.
You thought you knew stuff. You knew jack squat. But then what happened is these people all ended up on campus, and then the administrators are now treating them not like students, but they treat them like clients. Yeah. So they're like, oh, they act like they're running a resort. They're one of the Gabor sisters is staying in a cabana. Let's not anger Zsa Zsa.
Right.
Like, no, you're the parent. Tell them what to do. I mean, I guess when college got to be $250,000 for 4 years. I guess they did become clients, and now they need to be catered to.
Right.
And it's ridiculous. So someone needs them to shut.
Some of them would say there's a difference between exchanging idea and offensive hate speech. And in terms of market forces, they say, yeah, we are the customers. This is our university, and our point of view is this. And if you fight back and say, well, we've fought for our right to be there, then that idea wins. But
Well, I guess it's how you define hate speech. But, I mean, if you listen to Ben Shapiro or Dennis Prager or guy Jordan Peterson, it's not hate speech. These guys have strong opinions. And they're mostly always right. Sorry, 19-year-old idiots. Dennis Prager knows more than you. He should. He speaks 5 languages. He's 70 years old. He's been to every country on the planet. Okay, maybe he knows something you don't know. So he's going to share it. But if you don't want to go, don't go. I mean, that's the whole thing. I mean, I look at the activities of what's going on UC Berkeley. They have bands playing. They have different groups meeting. I would be interested. I wouldn't go. Just don't go.
No Safe Spaces is in select theaters now. Adam, good to see you this morning.
Thanks, Adam.
Jump back here in just a minute.